Hello. Just getting my exercise in for the day. Gotta train if you're gonna win the marathon.
Today's date is April 1st, 2020. Happy April Fool's Day. It's also my parents' anniversary. I gotta remember to text them. It is getting rough here in San Diego. We're already seeing our first patients coming into the hospital and into the clinic, and even some of my friends are getting infected and having to deal with that, of course, and trying to stay safe in the meantime. People often ask me, am I scared to go on the wards or see patients in clinic? No, I'm in clinic now. I think the best thing to know is be prepared. It's like being a Boy Scout, always be prepared. So I got up early this morning and worked out. Last night, while I was getting ready to go to sleep in bed, I was scrolling through my phone, which I guess everybody does now, but I came across some Anne Frank diary stuff. I was thinking that, oh my gosh, I'm writing a diary. I hope this story ends better. So I'm walking into work today, wearing my mask. Yesterday seemed pretty calm. Today I woke up this morning to a whole bunch of people texting me and paging me. Our surge hasn't even really hit yet. And I think that also causes a lot of anxiety, knowing that it's coming and knowing that people are already tired. We are working now to set up clinical trials. I'm leading one of these efforts in the United States, which is daunting since everything has to be done so quickly. Back in January, I saw some reports that this medication called hydroxychloroquine could be used to treat COVID-19. I'm like, huh, that's interesting. There was a study in France that showed that it did work, and another study that shows that it didn't work. To really figure this out, you need to do a randomized, controlled, blinded, with placebo trial. None of that was happening. And then the president gets on TV and says, oh, you can just use hydroxychloroquine and that'll treat your coronavirus. I don't know if that's the case, but then everybody who loved President Trump goes online and says, yes, we'll just use hydroxychloroquine. And then everybody who hates President Trump goes online and goes, oh, that's risky. Look at this study, it causes heart problems. And the science doesn't care about politics. It doesn't care whether you are a Republican or a Democrat. It only cares about finding out the truth. I am working harder now than I actually worked when I was an intern. I know that Asher, my husband, is pretty tired of me, I think, coming in late in the night, leaving early in the morning, never seeing me, rummaging around, getting food, leaving messes everywhere. He'll forgive me though, but I do think this is kind of tiring for him too. You know, it feels good after a long day, a shower, a workout in the shower, which was good, but I'm headed to bed now. It's May 1st, my clinical trial looking at hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin open today. It's so exciting. I hope it works. Things are getting a little busy. We were holding pretty steady over the past few days in the number of patients in the hospital, but it looks like it's going into the weekend. We're gonna see a little bit of increased patients. We're getting more transfers from other hospitals who want to use our ventilators or our heart bypass machines, and it's a little worrisome.
Every day is something in the news. How did a virus become politicized? It's just sort of astounding to me.
Today, the FDA sent this announcement rescinding the emergency use authorization for hydroxychloroquine for the use of inpatients, so people who are hospitalized. I've always said that. Don't use it for the hospital for treatment. Just test it, see if it works. So now the study's just sort of limping along. Not many people are enrolling.
I don't know if it's going to continue. So that's the bad news. The good news is, because we were able to get the trial set up so quickly, the NIH tapped me and my group to do an even larger study. It's pretty exciting. So there's a whole bunch of new drug coming out. It's the next wave of treatment. And my trial is going to be the one that's going to be used to test all these agents on an outpatient basis. I just don't feel like I am being efficient enough with the emails, with getting the studies together, with taking care of my patients. I just feel like I feel like I'm just letting everybody down by not being able to do all those things at the same time. Maybe that's crazy to think about, but it's how I feel at the moment. So it's Wednesday morning, getting ready to head to work, enjoying the birds. Feels the same, but it just fundamentally isn't the same anymore. And I've just been thinking about what that means. It's like once you're stretched, you just can't ever go back to the same form. You're just never the same again. And that's sort of what this pandemic has been like for me. I just feel so different, like the world is gonna change. And even if we get a vaccine and a treatment and everything goes back to normal, I won't go back to normal. I'm different.